I see bugs.
Yo guys, I'm sorry I should be back with another video. Today's a how-to video. Today's gonna be how to wheelie. So we're gonna teach you guys today how to wheelie on a geared bike, a mountain bike, and obviously over there, single speed big flyer. So yeah, let's get into it. Alright, so we're gonna get to the first step. The first step I would say is just to get comfortable with your bike. Make sure you're riding around like this. Riding around normally. Make sure you're comfortable with the bike. Also, make sure you're comfortable where your seat is at. I like my seat high because I'm a tall person. So I like it around about hip height. For you guys, it might be down low because you're small. Or for me, it's not high because I'm tall. So yeah, so make sure you're comfortable with your bike when you're riding.
So the second step would be just getting comfortable, make sure you always think you're wearing the brake when you're trying to learn to get ready to check it. Because I learned without it, and that messed me up when I started trying to use it because I got like distracted. It took me a lot more time when I could be learning different tricks like one hand and stuff like that.
So the first step for wheeling is make sure you got your timings right and make sure you're using your dominant foot. So right now my right foot is my dominant foot. So I'm going to show you how I pull out with my right foot. My right foot is going to be up. I'm going to pull up like that. You're putting all the pressure on your strong foot to pull up, and then when you're going too much back, you just cut that brake.
Adding on to point three, you've got to make sure you're in a comfortable seat if you're riding a bike, and you've got to make sure, like say, you push down with your weak foot down and pull up with your dominant foot. It's timing, so you'll practice and get the timing right. For example.
When you pull up with your strong foot, your dominant foot, you need to tap that brake. Make sure you have your finger on your brake, just because you need to make sure that you're on the balance point. When you get to your balance point, you're tapping that brake or sever it. Even when the brake pads are rubbing to your disc, make sure you're not going all the way back, you're just covering it. I'll show you a little example now.
The balance point is the time where you're not really like, you don't have to use your back brake as much as you would do if you're not in the balance point. So.
Key to step five is really just practice getting used to your back brake, feathering it, not so it's not, so you're not sharp, janky movements, like you're smooth, and then just practice to go further, start practicing new tricks. There's a tutorial on the size channel, one hand. Try to learn that and maybe your first trick, or try to practice taking one leg off or something. Just practice. Unlike a mountain bike, you don't pull in and out, you do the same pedal technique, but you pull, it's less in the arms, you pull back on your body weight. For example, step three is you want to get to know where your seat is, like comfortable most comfortable weight position. So for me, I like it just below my waist. Some people like it high, some people like all the way down low. If you have it all down low, it's better for combos, it's better for deep. So basically, with my seat, I find it easier and more comfortable to tilt it forwards. So when you go back into a balance point, you're going to be like more steady. Another thing with the seat is just the lower it is, the higher back your balance point is going to be. The higher it is, the lower down your balance point is going to be. So that you can use that to get comfortable and get used to your balance point. The fifth and final step is practice, because this sometimes takes a long time and it'll eventually come to you.
See you tomorrow in the next video. Let's get it!